Walking around here, it makes you feel like you are a world away. It's a wonderfully secluded location with a great deal of natural beauty.
You open this gate and suddenly you're down into this valley. The valley has this amazing water course with hemlocks, a big pond, this huge space that otherwise you didn't know existed. And it was just sort of an amazing thing to see that there's this place that's just off of campus that has this whole world in it that provides an opportunity to go out and interact with it.
The site is a 75-acre nature preserve owned by the university.
This new piece of the university property that's a wildlife sanctuary and an outdoor laboratory. In the environmental studies program, students are sort of challenged to think about how they might want to shape the world around them. What Nuthatch Hollow represents in the context of environmental studies then is a place that we can look at how do we shape the natural environment around us to create a world that is sustainable for humans as well as the plants and animals that we live around here, particularly here in New York State.
So we're in the process of designing what's called a living building, and that building will house some classroom space, some research space, and also be able to be used for community outreach. There are currently 11 certified living buildings in the world. We're not going to be the first, but we are going to be on the leading edge. What makes this building unique, even as a living building, is that we are using the building itself to conduct research about energy and water, which means that the systems that we use may not be the same throughout the life cycle of the building.
What we're trying to do is build it to a standard that's far beyond what anybody currently does, to the point where the building isn't just doing the least bad, but actually the most good. I see this as a blank canvas for how do we build a building here that doesn't impact the water quality and the air quality and the plants around it. How do we enrich the water sources that are here to make sure that as we use the building on the property, we don't contaminate the water sources.
Everything that goes into this building has to be environmentally sound. And that's not just that it's non-toxic in its use, but also that it was non-toxic in its production and would be non-toxic in its disposal.
And the important part here is that students get to be engaged in that process and sort of see the conceptual learning turn into actual practice, the hub of activity for students and faculty.
This will serve as a model for how to live in harmony with nature rather than having an impact on it.
This will be really a showcase for this region, definitely.